Children, in our last video, we discussed about the compound interest. Yes, the interest which is compounded annually, that is each year, right? Because of that, the principal each year changes, okay? So that means if we are finding the interest for 3 years, compound interest for 3 years, then what will happen? We will find the simple interest of first year. Yes, that interest gets added to the principal, okay? Then we go to the second year. We find the interest that gets added to the principal again, and then we go to the third year and we find. So this process carries on, right? This process carries on. Okay, that means it's a long process. Suppose if you get a question to find the compound interest for 5 years, then it will become very difficult for us to solve and get the answer, right? So let's see if we can have any formula for compound interest. Now, how to get the formula for compound interest? I know you must be thinking this. So, we were finding the compound interest how? P into R into T by 100. And we were taking T as 1 year. If years is 3, we were doing this 3 times. Right? Each year we were adding the interest to the principal like this. And we were taking the new principal and then going ahead for the next year. So, we are going to do that only here. Let's see if we can get any formula. Okay, let's start. So suppose here the principal is P, rate is R, time is 2 years. Okay, time is 2 years. Okay. Sound was that? Continuing back, children. So if time is 2 years, that means we are going to find this 1 year separately. Okay. So let's start. Let's take the interest as P into R into T by 100. Let's take time as 1 year. So this becomes PR by 100. Okay. This is the interest for the first year. Now, we will add this to the principal. Why? Because we used to do that, no? For first year, whatever interest used to come, we used to add it to the principal. So, we will get the new principal. So, what is the new principal, children? That is old principal. I am writing new principal, old principal. New. This is just to not create the confusion. Okay. So, old principal plus the interest, that is this SL, interest. What is your old principal? P only. What is your interest? PR by 100. Children, we can take P common. P into 1 plus R by 100. Okay. This is your new principal, which we are going to put in the second year to find the interest. Now, what is interest? P into R into T by 100. Now, T is again 1 year. So, this becomes PR by 100. Now, what is this? This is the new principal. So, we'll put the value of new principal. That is So, let's separate it and write, children. Okay, so that we will not get confused. P into R by 100. You can see here, P I have separated R by 100. Now, let's go to P. What is P? The new principal. That is P into 1 plus R by 100 into R by 100. Okay? Correct? Now, we multiply, we write these two together. So, P R by 100 into 1 plus R by 100. Okay? This is your new interest. This is your new interest. Now, we have to write the amount. Krishna, Sona Didi, niche hai babu. Niche hai. Didiya niche hai, lock karke gayi hai. Chabi mama ke paas nahi hai, bhai mama paas. Aap wahan se chale jao. Jao, jao. जाओ जल्दी जाओ नानी भी आई है नानी भी आई है जाओ आप नानी पास चले जाओ गो ओके sorry for the disturbance, children. A is the new principal plus this interest. Now, what is your new principal, children? This is your new principal. That is P into 1 plus R by 100. And what is your interest? This is your interest. PR by 100 into 1 plus R by 100. Okay? Now, anything you can see common? This is common. So, let's take it as common. So, let's write P. Okay? What is left here? P is left here. Plus, what is left here? PR by 100. And what we took common? We took this entire bracket common, right? 1 plus R by 100. Okay? Now, children, you see here, you can take this P common. So, put it out. 1 plus R by 100. 1 plus R by 100. Now, this is what? 2 times. That is P into 1 plus R by 100 whole square. Okay, that means this is the formula to find the amount which is compounded annually for 2 years, right? We took it for 2 years. So, it is coming 2 times. If it had been for 3 years, it would have been come 3 times. If it would have been n years, it would have come n times, right? So, actually the formula is P into 1 plus R by 100 raised to, either you write T or you can write N, where N denotes the time or T denotes the time. Okay, children? So, this is very, very simple. If you remember, if you try to, this is, I know you will remember. Okay, P into 1 plus R by 100. Raised to N, where N is the time. Okay? N is the time. 2-3 small things more are there. Like for example, if in the interest, it is asked for 3 years and 2 months. 3 years and 2 months. So, if we take out 3 years as compound interest and this 2 months we take out as simple interest. Okay? And this 2 months becomes what? 2 by 12. That is 1 by 6. Okay, children? If this is asked, compound interest is asked half yearly. Half yearly means, like for example, 6 months. Okay, so you can take this as 1. Now, 6 months means you cannot take like this 2 by 12, 1 by 6. So, better to put the rate half. Okay, like for example, if the rate is 12%, so for 6 months, it will be half, that is 6%. Okay, children? One more thing, I am forgetting to tell you all about it. It just came in my mind and it has gone, children. Yes, this is what, this is the formula for compound interest to find the amount which is compounded periodically, I will say. Okay, that is depending upon the time. Got it? Now, if you want to know the interest, if you want to know the interest, so then from this amount, you just subtract the principal. Okay, from this amount, whatever amount comes, we subtract the principal. Okay, why? Because in this compound interest, we directly get the amount. But in simple interest, we get the interest, and then if we want to know the amount, then what we do? We do principal plus interest, right? But when it comes to the compound interest, we directly get the amount. Okay, we directly get the amount. And if we want to know the interest, if we not want to know the interest, then what do? We subtract the amount, whatever answer comes after this formula. Okay, if when we put the values in this formula, whatever answer comes in that, from that we subtract this principal. Like for example, if your principal is 10,000 and your interest has come as 11,000 200, your amount has come after your compound interest, after you have solved the, put the values and solved the question and you got this answer. This is your amount. Okay, now if you want to know the interest, then what do? You subtract A and P, that is A minus P, that is 11,200 minus 10,000. Okay, and your answer comes out to be 1200. Clear, children? This much is clear. Okay, now there are certain applications which we are going to do. Okay, fast. So that we'll understand more about this compound interest. And one more thing, children. This chapter is not coming in your term 2. This is for your term 2 activity. Okay, two sums from this I'm going to give you all. And you will have to do it in the live session. Okay, we are going to have a live session and then you are going to do it so that it becomes very easy to collect the answers also, because you know sometimes you all send and then from my phone the data gets deleted, so I am not able to give you the marks. So better to have a live session tomorrow or day after tomorrow. We are going to have a live session and then we will solve the question on compound interest, and you don't have to panic at all. If you are not able to do, I am going to explain you there also in the live session also. Okay, don't think that I am not able to solve, then what will I do, what will I show ma'am? No problem, we are going to discuss and then you will solve. Okay, because it's just like an activity, that is subject enrichment. Okay, so I am going to provide all the facilities for you to get enriched in compound interest. Okay, so let's do the sums, but a small break I need. Okay.